Good evening and welcome to Algona Bishop Garrigan High School as we get set for Top of Iowa Conference Volleyball tonight between the Forest City Indians and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Good evening, everybody. I'm Sarah Negestal high above Bishop Garrigan's gymnasium as the Golden Bears out there warming up right now. Forest City is finished up some of their warm-ups, and both teams will continue to warm up as we get set for starting lineups and everything to get going here in just a couple of minutes. This is the Kingland Construction pregame show, Kingland Construction Service of Forest City. Kingland is proud of North Iowa and loves to support our area in many different ways. When you need a building, house, outer building, or even remodeling done, call Kingland Construction Service today at 641-585-0101. That's 641-585-0101. Kingland Construction Service in Forest City. Give them a call for all of your construction needs. Thanks so much to Eric and his crew and everything they do here for North Iowa. As we get set, Forest City with a victory tonight. Everybody's got something on the line. Forest City with a victory tonight can eliminate everybody from the conference race except for Lake Mills. Bishop Garrigan with the win tonight, they can keep themselves alive in the conference hunt and send it on to see what happens between Forest City and Lake Mills. But if Bishop Garrigan is unable to defeat the Indians tonight, everybody will be eliminated from the conference contention except for Forest City and Lake Mills. And if everything goes the way the Indians and the Bulldogs would like to have it, 1 week from tonight, conference championship volleyball right here on KIOW. But we'll have to see. We get there, obviously, you know, everything is day-to-day at this point. When we look at the volleyball teams right now, Eagle Grove is unable to be playing, and just right now everything is really day-to-day. So stay with us, and we'll see. But right now, as the way it's looking right now, Forest City with a victory tonight can get themselves to another conference championship volleyball matchup 1 week from tonight with the Lake Mills Bulldogs. Forest City is 3-2 in their last five. The Indians are 12-7 overall. Forest City is 6-0 in the Top of Iowa West Conference. And their opponent tonight, on the other hand, the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears are 10-8 overall under 20th year head coach Dave Schnurr. And they are 4-1 in the Top of Iowa Conference. As I mentioned, can kind of keep their hopes alive. They gave Lake Mills a little bit of a run. They took Lake Mills deep in a lot of sets, but were unable to find a victory over the Bulldogs. And now kind of their conference season on the line here this evening. As we mentioned, under 20th year head coach Dave Schnurr. Thanks to my good friend Dana Becker over at the Fort Dodge Messenger for uncovering that for me today. I was unable to find that one, so I appreciate him uncovering that one for me. And he's taking on, we'll talk about him later on as well, but 10th year Forest City head coach Lacey Jerome. As mentioned, the Indians are 12-7 and 6-0 in the Top of Iowa West Conference. Well, a lot of really good athletes on this Bishop Garrigan team, and that's what has given them this position, a team that played for a lot of these same girls played for a basketball state championship just a few months ago, and now see themselves doing good when it comes to volleyball as well. They are a team that took some sets from some really good teams last year. They took a set from Forest City. That was the first time ever that a Bishop Garrigan volleyball team had taken a set from Forest City last year in 2019. Other than that, since 2014, when these two teams started to match up, it was 3-0, 3-0, 3-0 all the way up until last year when Bishop Garrigan took a set from Forest City last year, but the Indians came back to win that one 3-1. Bishop Garrigan is also 3-2 in their last five sets. Their last five sets are a 2-1 victory over Garner Hayfield Ventura, a 2-0 victory over West Hancock Southeast Valley, and then their couple of losses were a 1-2 loss, or rather a 2-1 loss to St. Ansgar, the number 15 team in Class 1A, and then a loss to Kemper Catholic, who's also a team on the rise as well. One of the things that I've kind of talked about a couple of times throughout our broadcasts this year as Forest City, their only losses, we'll talk about this more on, but Forest City's only losses have come to ranked teams. Forest City does have a victory over a ranked team, Lake Mills, in a tournament earlier this season, but Forest City's seven losses all come to ranked teams, and when you listen to them, it's just amazing. The number one, and these are all current, not what they were when they lost to them, but currently they lost to the number one team in Class 3A. They lost to the number four team, or rather the number six team in Class 4A three times. That's Waverly Shell Rock. They lost to the number four team in Class 5A Cedar Falls one time, and they've also lost to the number 12 team in Class 3A Roland Story, along with the number three team in Class 3A in Clarion Goldfield Dowse. So all ranked teams that that Forest City has fallen to so far this season. All right, let's take a look at the starting lineups tonight. First for Bishop Garrigan, the starting lineups, as we mentioned, some really good athletes, some names you're going to recognize as we go through these. Definitely some names you hear in different sports. We also had the softball game on this summer as well, so you heard some of them then. But number one is Bailey Meister. She is the libero. She's a senior at 5'3". Number three is Anna Berkey. She's a senior defensive specialist at 5'3". Number four is Emma Granjanet. She's a junior middle hitter at 5'7". Number nine is the center. That's Reese Rosenmeyer. She's a senior center at 5'9". Number 10 is Gracie Elsbecker, a senior outside hitter at 5'8". Number 14 is Kaylin Meyer. She's a senior outside hitter at 5'10". And number 18 is Ani Crook. She is a sophomore right side at 6'3" for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Currently holding nine Division I basketball offers is Ani Crooks. We talked about her during the basketball season, but ever since her freshman basketball season concluded, the offers have just been rolling in. As we mentioned, nine Division I basketball offers for Ani Crooks. We'll talk more about that throughout tonight's game. All right, we'll take a break for the national anthem. We'll come back for a city starting lineups and first server right after this. You're listening to the Kingland Construction pregame show on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW as a small little mishap there. No, we are not doing the national anthem twice as they finished with it. It must have been on repeat because the national anthem started playing again. So we paused for a moment just in case they were going to go through with it again, but they don't. As we mentioned, Forest City 6-0 in the last 7 years against Bishop Garrigan. When it comes to sets one, Forest City is 18-1 all time against the Golden Bears. Starting for Forest City, Regan Helgeson, Kennedy Baker. Good to see her back full strength with the Indians, and Kaylee Miller up front for Forest City. In the back row for the Indians, it's Hannah Anderson, who will be replaced by the defensive specialist, the libero, Ellie Kaler, followed by on the right side is Kevin Jones, and on the left side of her is Shea Dillavu, the starters for Forest City, as with Hannah Anderson in the back row rotation for the Indians. We will see the libero, Ellie Kaler, come in for Forest City. Hopefully you're enjoying us here on the pregame show. That's going to conclude our pregame show, brought to you by our friends at Kingland Construction Service of Forest City. Kingland Construction Service of Forest City is proud of North Iowa and loves to support our area in many ways. When you need a building, build a house, outer building, or even remodel, call Kingland Construction Service today at 641-585-0101. All right, we are set and ready for volleyball. It is up and we are underway. Kaylin Myers going to knock the first one over for Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Shea Dillavu now for the Indians. Back the other way to the Bishop Garrigan side, trying to go to Audie Crooks. Instead, they go up to Kaylin Myers, and it's going to be blocked at the net. And Forest City is going to start off with the first point. We will work on the scoreboard up for you here in just a couple of seconds. Working on some technical problems, but we'll get it up for you. Forest City does get it over. Bishop Garrigan gets it back. Here come the Indians at the net. It's Kaylee Miller back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here comes Kaylin Myers with a big strike. Forest City will take it. Here come the Indians. Baker to Regan Helgeson. Helgeson will send it long, and it's 1 point apiece for each team as Forest City is one and done after getting the first point. Some of the best teams you're going to find in the top of Iowa Conference doing battle right here between the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears and the Indians. Here comes Kennedy Baker, now Regan Helgeson over for Forest City. Rosen Meyer's going to set it up, trying to set it up, but Bishop Garrigan is going to be unable to grab that one, and it's going to be a Forest City point, and the Indians now lead 2-1. So 2-1 the score, Forest City in the lead. Here from Bishop Garrigan High School. There's the served. Garrigan going after it. They're unable to get it, though, and Forest City is going to have back-to-back points for the first time in this contest. And it's now 3-1 Indians. Here comes Kaylee Miller's serve, taken by Bishop Garrigan. Rosenmeier sets it up to Crooks, and it's in off a block. Audie Crooks is able to bat that one in off a block. And Bishop Garrigan finds their second point. It's now 3-2 Forest City in the lead. And the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears will serve. Here comes Kaylee Miller. Miller will try to get it up, and Forest City unable to return that one. So Bishop Garrigan with back-to-back points now. 2-3. And it's now 3-3 our score between the Golden Bears and the Indians. Here comes the serve for Bishop Garrigan, taken by Kevin Jones. Set up by Kennedy Baker, over for Shea Dillavu, off the hands of Bailey Meister and out of bounds. And it's going to be a point for Forest City. So after back-to-back points for the Golden Bears of Bishop Garrigan, Forest City will get one back, and it's now 4-3. Serve will be coming for the Indians now. It's Ellie Kaler along the left side, her serve. Taken by the Golden Bears, Audie Crooks with a big strike, and that one's going to be in for a kill. Audie Crooks comes back and finds another kill for the Golden Bears, and it's 4-4. It won't be an easy one tonight for Forest City, as Tara Crone's going to come in for Audie Crooks, who goes out. Crone will be back to serve for the Golden Bears as Audie Crooks' position rotates to the back, and that one is sent long in a service error for Bishop Garrigan. The Golden Bears only 12% of the time are going to have that service error. 88% serve effectiveness this year for Bishop Garrigan, but that time they do, and Forest City gets the point back, and it's now 5-4. Kennedy Baker will serve for the Indians. Kaylin Myers one time. Rosen Myers sets it up. Here comes a big strike, but it's blocked to the net. Emma Grandjeanette went for a big swing, but Forest City gets the block, and the Indians get the point as Kennedy Baker will go back to serve once again for Forest City. Forest City leading 6-4 over Bishop Garrigan. Bishop Garrigan, Rosenmeier sets it up, big strike, and it's going to go in. That one off the hands of Rosenmeier as she trying to get it in. Comes with the big hammer. Here comes the serve over to the Forest City side. going to be off Warriors City. So a couple of points now for the Golden Bears. Have tied us back up at 6 apiece. And Bishop Garrigan will serve with Gracie Elsbecker along the right side. Elsbecker's serve taken by Ellie Kaler. Kennedy Baker at the net. Fight for it. Shane DeLavu knocks it in for a Forest City point. So the Indians get one back with Shane DeLavu. And Forest City now leads 7-6. And Shane DeLavu, after getting a big point for the Indians, will go back to serve. Kaelin Myers with a strike. Forest City diving for it, unable to get it. And it'll be a point for Bishop Garrigan's. The Golden Bears come back and find a point. And it's 7-7. Bishop Garrigan serving from the right side. Over to the Forest City side, Ellie Kaler. Kennedy Baker sets it up. Here comes Kaylee Miller with a strike taken by Bishop Garrigan. At the front of the net, Crone. Hannah Anderson just free balls it back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here comes Kaylin Myers with a strike. It's blocked to the net. Holland and Anderson for Forest City with a big block. Now Forest City trying to set it up. Anderson over, taken by Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Kaylin Myers. She'll just tap it over to the Forest City side. Kennedy Baker, Ellie Kaler, Kaylee Miller. Bishop Garrigan can't catch up to it. Molly Joyce running after it. And it'll be a point for Forest City. So the Indians will retake the lead 8-7. Molly Joyce, another one of those basketball stars, another sophomore for Bishop Garrigan. And Walker will come in to serve now for Forest City. Allison Walker's first serve is into the net, and it'll be a Bishop Garrigan point. Back and forth we go between Bishop Garrigan and Forest City. Allison Walker will come out after the serve. Hannah Anderson will go in, and then she'll come directly out as Ellie Kaler will go, as that position is in the back row. Here comes Bailey Meister's serve, and that's out. Bailey Meister sends it just a bit long for the Golden Bears. And everybody having a little problems with the serve this evening. And Forest City back in the lead, 9-8. Kevin Jones will serve for the Indians' left side. Serve coming, taken by the Golden Bears. Audie Crooks, Rosenmeyer, instead of setting it up, she just bats it over to the Forest City side. Here comes Regan Helgeson with a strike on the line and in. And Forest City gets a point. Big old swing there from Regan Helgeson right on the line. And it's in back-to-back points for Forest City. And they lead by two. It's 10-8. Serve coming from Kevin Jones, taken by the Golden Bears. Rosenmeyer again will just bat it over, free ball, and then Forest City free ball to it right into the hands of Annie Crooks, and she smashes it over for a Bishop Garrigan point. So after back-to-back Forest City points, Bishop Garrigan will get a point back, and it's now 10-9. And the Golden Bears will serve with Kaylin Myers to the Forest City side. Here comes Regan Helgeson, try to just finesse it over. Not quite enough, though. And it's going to be back-to-back points for Bishop Garrigan, and we're tied at 10. Kaylin Myers will serve once again for Bishop Garrigan. She'll send that one long, so it's going to be a Forest City point. Kaylin Myers, another one of those girls that came in early in her career and played from a young age for Bishop Garrigan. Now she's the senior on the court. Here comes Kaylee Miller. Audie Crooks trying to hit it back to the Forest City side on the line and in. Forest City thought it was out. Bishop Garrigan, though, just puts it right on the line. It's in. And back-to-back points for both teams, and we're tied at 11. Bishop Garrigan will serve once again from the right side. Serve coming, taken by the Indians, and Forest City's unable to return. And the Golden Bears will have back-to-back points and lead 12-11. Here comes the serve. Taken by Forest City. Kevin Jones, Kennedy Baker from the 10-foot line. Kaylee Miller now back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Kaylin Myers from the back row will send it long, and it'll be a Forest City point. So after Bishop Garrigan gets two, Forest City gets one. Nobody's had a bigger run tonight than two. Bishop Garrigan takes it. Rosenmeyer, Bailey Meister from the back row. Here comes Forest City. Kennedy Baker sets it up. Hannah Anderson goes over with it. Taken by the Golden Bears. And Kennedy Baker just out jumped Bonnie Crooks to the net for it and slaps it down on the Bishop Garrigan side. And Forest City's got back-to-back points. And it's 13-12. Forest City in the lead. And Forest City's got three straight. The Indians lead by two. Largest run of the ball game for Forest City to the Bishop Garrigan side. Off the serve, and it's down. Forest City with a run of four, their largest, and they lead 15-12. The biggest lead in this ball game for Forest City is 3 points. And the Golden Bears will make a change. Kaylin Myers will come out. Ashlyn Hovey, the sophomore outside hitter, will come in. Bailey Meister will take. Rosenmeyer will set up. Hovey tries to push it over, and she comes in. Excuse me, that was Elsbecker who slapped that one over and scores for the Golden Bears. Forest City's run ends at four, their largest. And Bishop Garrigan back on the board, back to a two-point deficit. It's 15-13, Forest City in the lead. Tara Crone will come in and serve. Crone's serve taken by Kaylee Miller. Kennedy Baker will just dump it over back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here come the Golden Bears. It's blocked to the net. Elsbecker trying to go over with it. Forest City with a monster block. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side, and the Indians score once again. And Forest City again back out to a three-point lead. It's 16-13. Forest City knew it wouldn't be easy, but trying to pick up this first one. Makes it a lot easier when it comes later on if they can pick up the first set. Kennedy Baker's serve taken by the Golden Bears. This one just shoved over by Grand Jeanette. It's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point, as they're going to call Forest City in the net. So the Golden Bears will get the point. Forest City's one and done, and Bishop Garrigan's got it back to a two-point deficit. It's 16-14. And the Golden Bears will serve, taken by Kaylee Miller, Kennedy Baker. Shea Dillavu over. Bailey Meister receives. Rosenmeyer sets it up. A little bit of a short set. It has to be just free ball to the Forest City side. Here comes Ellie Kaler. Holland over, and she's going to put it in for the Indians. Great play there by the freshman Sophia Holland as she gets it over, gets it in. Again, one of those doesn't have to be the hardest one she hits. But she's able to find the point, and Forest City again extends their lead to three. It's 17-14. And Bishop Garrigan can't return. It's a ace serve for the Indians. Back-to-back points for Forest City. And now their largest lead of four. Here comes Shea DeLavue's serve. Taken by the Golden Bears. A little bit of a short one. Pushed over. Free ball to the Forest City side. Baker. Hannah Anderson's blocked to the net, but the Indians will take back. Here comes Kaylee Miller with a strike. And it's a Forest City point. Bishop Garrigan was in the net. So the Indians extend their largest lead to five now and lead 19-14 coming down to the crucial portion of the set with Forest City leading. Here's the serve over the net. Bishop Garrigan, a little miscommunication going after it. Kaylin Myers will just lay it, trying to lay it over. She laid it into the net, and Forest City scores again. Another four-point run for the Indians, and they lead 20-14. And Shea DeLavue will serve. DeLavue's serve taken by Molly Joyce. Rosenmeyer trying to go after it. She is unable to get it. And Forest City scores again, their largest run of five. And they lead by seven. It's 21-14. Shea DeLavue over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. And they are unable to return. It's all Forest City right now. 22-14 is the lead for the Indians, and the Golden Bears gonna make a change as Ella Muller will come out, and Meredith Tigges, 5'9 junior middle hitter, will come in. Shea DeLavue's serve over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. Rosenmeyer sets it up to Myers, who's blocked the net on the line and in. It's a four. And they're gonna say it went out. Forest City crowd disagreed. Either way, the Indians have a 23-even the scoreboard agreed. Should be 22-15. So 22-15 is the score. Kennedy Baker will set that one up. Over to Hannah Anderson. Over to the Bishop Garrigan side block to the net and down. It's going to be a Forest City point. So the Indians get the Golden Bears one and done. It's now 23-15, and Forest City just 2 points away from taking it. And now they're finally going to correct the scoreboard here in a crucial spot, because the scoreboard has Forest City at 24 points, which means the Indians would only need one more, but it's actually 23-15. And now they'll fix it. So Allison Walker will send it over for the Indians to the Bishop Garrigan side. Bailey Meister. Tara Krohn will just, Grand Jeanette will just push it over. Here comes Regan Helgeson. Diving play made for it. Grand Jeanette just pushed it over. Now Dillavu with the diving play. Here comes a good play there by Regan Helgeson. Kaylin Myers pushes it over. Forest City keeps it alive somehow. Shea Dillavu just pushes it over. Again, Bishop Garrigan keeps it alive. And the Golden Bears will just free ball it over to the Forest City side at the net, and it's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point. Man, oh man. It will be a Bishop Garrigan point. And it will be 23-16 as the Golden Bears will need a big run, as Meister will go back to serve here for Bishop Garrigan. Had a little bit of a problem serving so far in this one. 21 aces on the year for Meister, and she gets one there as she sneaks it just into the back corner. It was either going to be out or it was going to be an ace, and it was an ace. And that's the 22nd ace of the year now for Bailey Meister. Serves at about 87%, but a couple of misses tonight will take that. Ellie Kaler, Kennedy Baker, Kaylee Miller over. Audie Crooks with a big strike. Shea Dillavu going after it. Forest City can keep it if they can keep it alive, and they cannot as it goes into the Forest City stands, and it's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point. Three straight for the Golden Bears has them back to within five as Bailey Meister will serve once again. Kaylee Miller, Kennedy Baker, Regan Helgeson blocked to the net. Forest City cannot return. And Bishop Garrigan now, their largest run of the ball game. It's four, and the Golden Bears are back to within four. Bailey Meister will serve once again. Taken by Kaylee Miller. Kennedy Baker. Sophia Holland over the net for the Indians. Here come the Golden Bears. Kaylin Myers will just tap it over. Kennedy Baker keeps it alive. Audie Crooks, though, battling for it at the net, and Audie Crooks is able to put it in a spot where Forest City can't get it. The Indians want a timeout as Bishop Garrigan has scored five straight points, and the Golden Bears are back to within three. We'll come back in 45 seconds for more volleyball action. It's Forest City 23. It's Bishop Garrigan 20. We'll come back right after this. Yeah. Welcome back to Bishop Garrigan High School as we get set for more Top of Iowa West Conference volleyball. Forest City can eliminate the Golden Bears from conference contention with a win. Bishop Garrigan can keep their conference title, at least a share of the conference title hopes alive. We got a long ways to go. We're in set number one. Forest City leading 23-20. Bishop Garrigan, though, trying to keep their run alive. They've got five straight to bring it back to within three. Bishop Garrigan has it on their side. Rosenmeyer sets it up. Here comes Kaylin Myers with a big strike. Forest City trying to get a point after the timeout. Here comes Sophia Holland, a big swing, but it's taken by the Golden Bears. It's halfway blocked. Audie Crooks will just free ball it over. Forest City will have a chance to set it up, and Kaylee Miller will just push it over. Here comes Rosenmeyer. She sets it up. Kaylin Myers at the net, pushes back to the Forest City side. Kennedy Baker, Holland blocked at the net. Forest City keeps it alive, though. Bishop Garrigan was celebrating too early. Here comes Audie Crooks, and she slams it home. And Bishop Garrigan has come all the way back to make it a 23-21 game. And the Golden Bears will serve with Bailey Meister. And it's into the net. Forest City is unable to get it back. Bishop Garrigan on a run. They're back to within one. The Golden Bears have scored 7 straight points and are back to within one. It's 23-22. Bailey Meister serve taken by Kaylee Miller. Forest City just trying to get the service back, get out of this rotation. Here comes Kaylin Meyer. She sends it over. Forest City takes it. Ellie Kaler over to Regan Helgeson over the net. Kaylin Myers. Rosenmeyer will just push it back. Regan Helgeson over, and Forest City is able to get it back. So the Indians get 1 point back, and Forest City is now just 1 point away from closing it out. It's 24-22. 24-22 is the score. Keevan Jones will serve. Over the net, taken by Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Audie Crooks, and she gets one in. So it's 24-23. Forest City still with an opportunity to win it if they can get a point here. Bishop Garrigan will serve. 24-23, Forest City trying to close it out with a point. Regan Helgeson over the net, and Bishop Garrigan cannot return, and Forest City closes it out here in set number one. The Indians made it close, but Bishop Garrigan is able to survive 25-23 after a 7-point run, but Forest City survives to win set one, 25-23. 2 minutes, we come back for more volleyball action live on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW. What a wild set number one we had. First of all, both teams, I wouldn't say struggled, just both teams very competitive in set or in the first part of the set. Neither team was able to muster together more than a run of 2 points or more. It was just a lot of back and forth. Forest City scores 2, Bishop Garrigan scores 2, back and forth. Forest City was finally able to break it open in the middle portion of the set when they scored 12, 13, 14, and 15 to lead by their largest lead of 4. The Golden Bears then came back, took a couple. Forest City took a couple here and there. Forest City had their largest run of the ball game at 6 points to take a commanding 8-point lead. But Bishop Garrigan says, hey, we're okay. And they score 7 straight from point 16 to point 22. And then they are able to find one more to make it 23-25. But Forest City is able to survive as the Indians fans a little bit away from us down the way a little bit. We're able to kind of breathe easy after that 25th point came in, because if Bishop Garrigan ties it up there and makes it 24-24, then it's anybody's game. It's just the first one to score 2 in a row. But Forest City had the luxury of only needing to score 1 point, where Bishop Garrigan needed to score a few points in a row and put together mustard, and then they had already put together 7. It's hard to put together runs like that in volleyball. And Bishop Garrigan was able to do it. Forest City started with the serve first in set number one, so Bishop Garrigan will start with the serve first here in set number two. And Bailey Meister is where they're going to start with, and she's the one that was serving during that seven-point run. She has 22 aces on the year, one of them already tonight as libero. She serves at about 86-85% for Bishop Garrigan, and she will start with it for the Golden Bears along the right side. Forest City is on the left side in their gray jerseys. Kennedy Baker up to Regan Helgeson, back over to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here come the Golden Bears. Kaylin Myers just free balls it over. Forest City side now. Here comes Sophia Holland. She tries to put one in, and it's going to go long, and it's going to be a point for Bishop Garrigan. So the Golden Bears, after having a big run, there to close out set number two. They start with the first point here, or rather set number one. They start off with the first point in set number two. A lot of numbers flying through my head. Kennedy Baker over to Regan Helgeson, back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here come the Golden Bears. Audie Crux will try to send one in, but she sends one out, and it'll be a Forest City point. So we start the same way we did in set number one, back and forth between the two teams, though it started the opposite way last time. Forest City started with the first point. Bishop Garrigan then came back and took one. Now Forest City starts, gets the second point as Bishop Garrigan takes the first one. Rosenmeier sets it up to Crooks. Crooks comes with a hammer. Forest City able to dig, though, with Ellie Kaler nearly winning the basket, but which is good because it would have been a Bishop Garrigan point, but it is going to be either way because Audie Crooks is going to go to the top of the net, and nobody can outreach 6'3". And she's able to lay it back down on the Forest City side, and it's now 2-1 Forest City trailing Bishop Garrigan. The Indians will need to take a big one back over, and they cannot. Bishop Garrigan with a large lead, or the largest lead we've seen thus far, of 2 points. Back-to-back points for the Golden Bears. Forest City takes now, trying to get it near the bottom of the net, and it's going to be another Bishop Garrigan Golden Bear point as the Golden Bears have come out firing. Something has lit a fire as they scored 7 to close out that last set loss, but now they've taken the first 5. Now make that the first 6 points, first 6 of the first 7 here. And Bishop Garrigan all over Forest City right now. Regan Helgeson sends it long. And Forest City desperately needing to stop the Bishop Garrigan run. 6-1 Golden Bears. And they serve into the net. That's exactly the kind of fresh air that the Indians needed. It's 6-2, Forest City trailing by 4. Largest deficit in this ball game for the Indians. This one over, and Bishop Garrigan unable to return. A Forest City serve now. And so the Indians get one back there. Trail 6-3. Kaylee Miller will serve for Forest City. Miller's serve over the net. Taken by Bailey Meister. It's an ace. One of Forest City's top servers gets an ace now. The 5'9 senior, Kaylee Miller, finds one. And Forest City with 3 straight points. They're back to within 2. It's 6-4. Over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. Trying to set it up to to Elsbecker. Instead, it's just going to be free balled over, tipped by the Indians, and it goes down. It's going to be a point for the Golden Bears. Forest City's run ends at 3. And it's now 7-4. Bishop Garrigan in the lead over Forest City. Here comes the serve, taken by Kaylee Miller. At the net, a fight for it, and Bishop Garrigan's going to win the battle at the net. And it's now 8-4 Golden Bears. Here comes the serve, taken by Kevin Jones. Kennedy Baker, Shea Dillavu over. This one's set up, and Elsbecker just lays it over. Forest City back the other way. Here comes, again, the set from Rosenmeier, and Forest City takes it and puts it into the net. So 3 more points for the Golden Bears. It's now 9-4 Bishop Garrigan. And we'll see a serve coming for the Golden Bears, taken by Forest City. Kennedy Baker to Regan Helgeson, and it's going to go into the net. 10 points now for Bishop Garrigan. 10-4 is the Golden Bear lead. And a serve will come for Bishop Garrigan, taken by Ellie Kaler. Kennedy Baker, far side to Shea Dillavu. She'll just lay it over. And Forest City will be able to stop the Bishop Garrigan run at four. So the Golden Bears have had runs of five and now four to lead 10-5. And Forest City will serve with Ellie Kaler over the net. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. Audie Crooks will just lay it. Kennedy Baker, not able to get it after. Kennedy Baker thought maybe it was going to go a little shorter and kind of had a fade away for it. It's now 11-5. Tara Crone will serve now for Bishop Garrigan. Taken by the Indians. Set up by Hannah Anderson, and the big dig for Bishop Garrigan will go out of bounds. So Forest City will have a point. It's now 11-6, the score. Scoreboard here at the high school again is off. 11-6. Taken by Bishop Garrigan over the net. Forest City will dig it out. Kaylee Miller over. Taken by Bailey Meister. This one's sent up, and a big block in off a block there for Bishop Garrigan. And it's now 12-6. Serve coming, taken from Hannah Anderson, Kennedy Baker, and Shea Dillavu is in the net. 13-6, the score for Forest City wants a timeout. It's been all Bishop Garrigan so far in this set. 13-6 is the Golden Bears lead. We'll come right back in 45 seconds on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW as we get set for more volleyball action. Forest City is trailing the Golden Bears of Bishop Garrigan 13-6 at the moment. And we will see Bishop Garrigan serving this one from the right side. Here we go, back to volleyball action, taken by Forest City. Kennedy Baker sets it up to Dillavu, tries to lay it over. Bailey Meister, a big dig, Forest City will take. Kennedy Baker sets it up. Shea Dillavu over, and Bishop Garrigan touches it, and it goes out of bounds. It's gonna be a Forest City point. So the Indians come out of the timeout and stop Bishop Garrigan. Just a 2-point run there for the Golden Bears. 13-7 is the score. Forest City trying to get back into this one, as Bishop Garrigan did in the first one, though they went down early. Forest City did in this one, so plenty of time to come back. Kaylin Myers at the net. Forest City will take. Kennedy Baker will just free ball it over the net. Bishop Garrigan will be able to set it up now. Grand Jeanette sends it over. Here comes Forest City's Kaylee Miller. She's just going to send it over. Molly Joyce. Now Bailey Meister over, taken by the Indians. Here comes Ellie Kaler. Sophia Holland over, and she sends that one a bit long. And so Forest City is one and done. Bishop Garrigan back onto the scoreboard, and it's 14-7. Forest City trailing 14-7 here in set number two. The Indians took set number one, 25-23. Forest City can knock Bishop Garrigan out of the conference race with a win tonight. That one sent long by Anderson. And it's now 15-7. Forest City trailing big here in set number two. Kaylee Miller, a big dig back to the Bishop Garrigan side, and it's just sent straight back down. And it's all Bishop Garrigan right now. 16-7 is the score. And again, we'll see a serve coming for the Golden Bears. Kennedy Baker, and the Indians miscommunication Somebody was in the wrong place. And that one will fall to the floor, and Forest City is going to have to use another timeout. It's 17-7. Forest City trails by 10. We'll come right back for more volleyball action in 45 seconds on KIOW. Welcome back. Forest City trying to set one up at the net. A battle for it at the net, though. Bishop Garrigan is into the net with the volleyball, and it'll be a Forest City point. So Forest City gets one back now after falling behind by 10 points. It's 17-8. Forest City looking for a big comeback, and the Indians are going to need a little bit of a run. Though they've got a pretty good server in to do it, and they're going to go after that run. It's Allison Walker who will come in to serve, and Grand Jeanette will take it. Now from the back row, a strike into the net for Molly Joyce. So Joyce sends one into the net. It's now 17-9 for Forest City with back-to-back points. Forest City hasn't had more than 3 points in a row in this set. They trail 17-9. Took set number one, now trailing in set number two. This one's set up to Kaylin Myers. Her block back to the Forest City side. Kaylee Miller with a big battle at the net, and it's going to go in the ceiling on the Forest City side off of Bishop Garrigan. And so it's going to be a Forest City point, and the Indians at their largest run of 3 points and back to within seven. They don't need to get them all back right here. Can get three, four, five, and then maybe lose one, and then come back, get three, four, five. That one's tipped, and it'll be off of Forest City. So the Indians get three. Now they got to have Bishop Garrigan go one and done for a couple of turns here and not let the Golden Bears go on a little bit of a run. 18-10 is the score in favor of Bishop Garrigan. The Golden Bears are closing in on trying to get set number two for his city, looking for a comeback. Here comes Regan Helgeson over the net, trying to set it up to the middle to Audie Crook. She's just going to have to free ball it over to the Forest City side. Here comes Ellie Kaler over, taken by Bailey Meister. It's set up to Kaylin Myers, and it's pushed back to the from the Forest City side by Kennedy Baker over to the Bishop Garrigan side. Baker found just a small little crack in the Golden Bear defense and was able to stick it in. So Forest City gets Bishop Garrigan one and done there and gets it back, trailing 18-11. Now Forest City going to look for another run. Kevin Jones will serve left side. Jones' serve taken by Bishop Garrigan, and the Golden Bears will free ball to the Forest City side. Kennedy Baker sent it up to Regan Helgeson over the net. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. They're going to send it up to Crooks, and she sends it in. And it's 19-11. 19-11 is the score. Bishop Garrigan leading Forest City here in set two. Kevin Jones takes. Here's Kennedy Baker over to Kaylee Miller. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here comes Kennedy Baker over Kaylee Miller, taken by the Golden Bears. And that one's sent long. No, they're going to say that Forest City tipped it. So it was sent long. I think it's the first time one of the line judges has called one long tonight. But they're going to say Forest City tipped it first, so it's going to be 20-11. Here comes Kaylee Miller over, taken by Bailey Meister. This one set up by Kaylin Myers, and that one is going to be on the line and in. This set's starting to belong to Bishop Garrigan, or rather, actually has belonged to Bishop Garrigan about the whole way. It's 21-11, Golden Bears in the lead over Forest City. Big here in set number two. Forest City took set number one. This one's sent up by the Indians. Here comes Kaylee Miller with a big strike. Forest City looking for some momentum. Kaylee Miller trying to bring it. Forest City will get one back. 21-12 the score. And a serve will come for the Golden, or rather for the Indians, is Kaylee Miller. Miller's serve over, taken by Bishop Garrigan. Now to the Forest City side. Just free ball to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here come the Golden Bears. Elsbecker sends it long, and Forest City's got a couple of back-to-back points. A little momentum for the Indians, but they're going to need a lot more where that came from as they trail 21-13. Going to need a big run. Kaylee Miller's serve taken by Bishop Garrigan. Audie Crooks just free balls it over. Kevin Jones takes it. It ends up in the hands of Dillavu, who just sends it over. Audie Crooks with a strike off a block. Sent up by the Indians. Kaylee Miller just has to bat it over. Rosenmeier sets it up. Elsbecker strikes, and that one's in. So Bishop Garrigan comes back and scores. And it's now 22 after Forest City got two in a row. It's 22-13. Serve coming. Taken by the Indians. Hovinga. And Kaylee Miller sends it long. 23-13. Bishop Garrigan continuing to roll here. As we'll see the serve coming for the Golden Bears, taken by the Indians. Sent up by Hovinga over the net and will be sent long. And Bishop Garrigan now just 1 point away from taking it at 24-13. Taken by the Indians, and Forest City cannot return. It's all Bishop Garrigan in set number two. 25-13 is the final. We'll come back in 2 minutes. We'll come back for more volleyball action. 1-1 apiece. We head to set number three, brought to you by our friends at A&W Family Restaurants in 2 minutes. Welcome back here on KIOW as we get set for set number three. Our set threes this year are brought to you by our good friends at A&W Family Restaurants in Forest City. They have delicious sandwiches, shakes, cheese curds, and of course, that home-brewed rip beer daily from 11 a.m. until 9 p.m. A&W, where the food is as good as the rip beer, Highway 69 North in Forest City. Once again, thanks to our friends at A&W. Still plenty of time to get down to your local Forest City A&W store before they close up shop around 9 p.m. this evening. But if you do miss out tonight, remember they'll be back open at 11 o'clock tomorrow for your eating pleasures. All right, here we go. Set number three. I guess we've seen it about everything here for the first two. It was back and forth in set number one. Then Forest City dominated the middle portion. Bishop Garrigan made a little bit of a run, but the Indians were able to hold on. And then it was all Bishop Garrigan for the most part in set number two. And they take that one by a final score of 25-13. The final in that one. So kind of been a couple of different stories here. Forest City will serve first this time. That's so far, if you're looking at trends of the match. It's been whoever takes, who serves first so far has won. So we'll see if that plays out again here in this one. This is a crucial set because the winner of this one doesn't has the pressure off a little bit. The loser of this one would have to win two straight. And Audie Crooks starts with the first point for Bishop Garrigan as the Golden Bears come back firing. Once again with a point. Again, Bishop Garrigan has never taken more than one set from Forest City. Block at the net, but it goes out of bounds off of Bishop Garrigan. So Forest City will get one back. Bishop Garrigan is one and done here with their first serve. And Kaylee Miller will serve for the Indians. And I guess they're looking for a volleyball. And Kaylee Miller says there was some moisture, some water on the volleyball. They're trying to find a towel for it. She's just going to use her shirt instead. And gets it all cleaned off. Here we go. We're ready for volleyball. Bailey Meister digs it out for the Golden Bears. A big strike for Bishop Garrigan. Forest City, though, with a couple of big digs to keep it alive. And it's going to be a point for Bishop Garrigan, though, as Forest City's called with a double hit. A couple of massive digs there for the Indians. Looking for some momentum. But Bishop Garrigan is able to get the point after Forest City double hits it. And it's 2-1 Golden Bears. And we'll see a serve coming for Bishop Garrigan, taken by the Indians. A low-lining serve, and Bishop Garrigan is able to get it in. Forest City unable to return. It's now 3-1 Golden Bears early here in set number three. Here comes the serve, and it's going to be an ace. An ace serve for the Golden Bears. Rosenmeyer, the server for Bishop Garrigan. And starting the same way we ended the last set, all Bishop Garrigan. Here come the Indians, trying to get this one back over to the Garrigan side. Taken by Garrigan now. Grandjeanette just lays it over. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Bailey Meister, Audie Crooks trying to send one down. Forest City able to keep it alive, and it will go out. Even Jones using her knee there to keep that one alive, but it goes out of bounds. Five to one, Bishop Garrigan leading Forest City here in set number three. Kennedy Baker to Regan Helgeson. It's blocked to the net. And Bishop Garrigan gets another one. Golden Bears have found some life here in set two and now set three. They lead 6-1, same they did in the last set. Kevin Jones, Kennedy Baker, over to Shea Dillavu. And they say it wasn't blocked at the net. Shea Dillavu thought there was a block, so Forest City would have been able to hit it again. But the referee says it was not blocked. It was into the net right back to Shea Dillavu. She can't touch it again. And it's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point. It's 7-1. Here comes Forest City now, trying to keep it alive. The Indians get it back to the Garrigan side. Here comes Audie Crooks, blocked at the net. Kennedy Baker trying to get one in. She does. So Kennedy Baker able to squeeze one in there for Forest City. A 6-point run for Bishop Garrigan, though, has them a 7-2 lead. Here comes Audie Crooks, and miscommunication there from Forest City. Nobody went after it. That one just goes straight down to the court. And it's 8-2. Bishop Garrigan in the lead. Crone will come in to serve, the senior. Kennedy Baker now to Shea DeLevue over the net. Crone will send it up. Kaylin Myers over the net, taken by Ellie Kaler. And Forest City will send it back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Rosenmeyer will set it up to Elsbecker, back to the Forest City side. Here comes Shea DeLevue over the net. Crone, Bishop Garrigan trying to keep it alive. They do. Forest City thought maybe Bishop Garrigan was across that half-court line, because you can go out of bounds to go get it, but you can't cross that half-court line. And apparently they were not, and they get the point. Back-to-back points here again for Bishop Garrigan, and it's 9-2 Golden Bears. Kennedy Baker sends it up. And Shea DeLevue into the net. Bishop Garrigan just on a tear here as of late. Set two, set three have been all Bishop Garrigan. And that one served in the net. So Forest City gets a break as the Golden Bears serve one into the net. And now Forest City looking for a little bit of a comeback here. Very crucial set, because the loser of this one will have to win two straight. So Forest City going to come back, or trying to come back and put them in a good position. Here's a strike, and it's blocked, but blocked down to the Forest City side. It's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point, and Forest City is not finding any runs, and it's 11-3 Golden Bears. Serve coming for Bishop Garrigan, taken. Kennedy Baker sets it up. Hannah Anderson pushes it over. Here comes the Golden Bears. Kaylin Myers at the net, and she sends one home. Bishop Garrigan will find back-to-back points again. Forest City wants a timeout. Bishop Garrigan leading 12-3 here in set three. We'll take 45 seconds to come back for more volleyball on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW. More volleyball action underway now as Kennedy Baker will send this one up. Holland trying to go over with it into the net. More points for the Golden Bears. It's now 13-3. Bishop Garrigan in the lead. And the serve will come for the Golden Bears, and it's going to be an ace. 14-3. Bishop Garrigan has runs now of 6-3 and now a run of 4 to lead 14-3. This one tips over the net. Forest City digs it, but it goes out of bounds. And it'll be another Bishop Garrigan point. 15-3 now the lead for the Golden Bears. Ellie Kaler, Kennedy Baker, Kaylee Miller at the net. Ranginette trying to go over with it, but she goes into the net. So the run will stop there at 15-4. And it's a 5-point run for Bishop Garrigan. And lead Forest City 15-4. Ranginette over. Forest City trying to keep it alive. Ellie Kaler's got to take it over the net. She does. This one's blocked to the net. But out of bounds off of Forest City. And Bishop Garrigan gets another one. 16-4, all Golden Bears. Bishop Garrigan 16, Forest City 4. And it's going to be an ace for the Golden Bears. Leading 17-4 now. Serve over the net. Taken by the Indians. Kennedy Baker. Kaylee Miller over. Kaylin Myers for Bishop Garrigan. Rosenmeyer back to Myers over. Forest City takes. Ellie Kaler. Kaylee Miller's just got to go over with it. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Rosenmeyer, Grand Jeanette. She bumps it over. Forest City unable to get it. 18-4. And Bishop Garrigan leading this one. Serve coming. Ellie Kaler, Kennedy Baker, Kaylee Miller over, and that's in. Forest City is going to need a lot here in set number two, but what they can do is trying to build some momentum. Lake Mills 3-0 over North Iowa, 25-11, 25-14, 25-13. So Lake Mills Bulldogs find another conference victory. Trying to set up that showdown next Tuesday, but in order for it to be for the outright title, Forest City's got to win here tonight. Holland over, taken by the Indians. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Hannah Anderson, Kennedy Baker pushes it over for Kaylee Miller. Kaylee Miller now, Bishop Garrigan with Grand Jeanette, and she's into the net. And Forest City will have back-to-back points. 18-6, Bishop Garrigan in the lead. And this one's going to go out of bounds off of the Golden Bears. Forest City making a little bit of a run, but is it too late? Too little too late here in set number two, trailing 18-7. They're going to need the run of the season to come back here in this one. Grand Jeanette digs it out, and it goes into the stands. Forest City running after it, unable to catch up to it. And it's going to be more points for the Golden Bears. Now 19-7. Forest City's run ends at two, their largest of the set. Bishop Garrigan back the other way. Bonnie Crooks, a block of the net, and it's a Bishop Garrigan point. 20-7 is the score. Bishop Garrigan in the lead over Forest City. And then the Golden Bears get this one. They just need one more. Forest City would need two, and it's an ace. Bailey Meister with her second ace of the match. Now has 23 on the season. And it's 21-7. And it's going to be a point. A lift is called against the Indians. 22-7. Bishop Garrigan, Forest City wants a timeout. We'll come back for more volleyball in 30 seconds on Key IOW. Welcome back here on Key IOW as we head towards the end of set number three, and Forest City would need an absolute monster of a comeback to find the win here in set number three. Our set three, of course, brought to you by our friends at A&W Family Restaurants in Forest City. But what the Indians could do is score some points and try to build some momentum, because they're going to need all the momentum they can get, because they're going to need sets four and sets five. Forest City has not been to a set five yet this year in conference play, and it starts off with a Bailey Meister serve into the net, so Forest City will get it back. So the Indians do start off on the right foot and get a point. It's 22-8. The Indians have scored 21 straight once this season. So they have done it, and now they score back-to-back. 22-9. So the Indians get back-to-back. Haven't had more than 2 points in a row in this set. Kevin Jones to serve. Serve's taken by Bishop Garrigan. This one's set up. Audie Crooks comes with it, and it's tipped and in. So it will be a Bishop Garrigan point. 23-9 now the score. And the Golden Bears will send it over to the Forest City side. Kaylee Miller trying to send it down. Bishop Garrigan will receive, though. Elsbecker sends it over. Here comes Kennedy Baker. Jaden Jerome over there in for Forest City. She tried to send it over. Back to the Forest City side. Here comes Shea Dilvu. Kaylin Myers takes one time. Rosenmeyer sets it up to Elsbecker and sends it long. ...23-10 is the score in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Taken by the Golden Bears, Rosenmeyer sets it up to Elsbecker and she sends it in. Bishop Garrigan just 1 point away from closing out set three and getting to a decisive set number four for them. Forest City then would need 4 and 5. Over the net. Kevin Jones, Kennedy Baker, Jaden Jerome. Blocked to the net, then she bats it back over to the Bishop Garrigan side. Good play there by Jerome. Forest City blocks Audie Crooks to the net. Shea Dilvu again blocks Audie Crooks at the net. Back-to-back blocks of Audie Crooks at the net for Forest City. Shea Dilvu. I think that's entertaining. Wait till these two get to basketball season. 24-11 is the score. Over to the Bishop Garrigan side. Here comes Audie Crooks. Sends this one to the Forest City side. Ellie Kaler. Now to Shea Dilvu. We'll just free ball it over. Bailey Meister sends it up to Rosenmeyer to Elsbecker. And she sends it in. Bishop Garrigan 25, Forest City 11 in set number three. We'll head to a set four where Bishop Garrigan can close it out when we come back in 2 minutes on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW as we get set for set number four. And, of course, Forest City has to win set four. They have to win set five. Now, looking back after all of what has happened here in set two and set three, how big was it for Forest City to hang on to that lead in set number one? Otherwise, Bishop Garrigan could have had a 3-0 here over Forest City. And the Golden Bears looking for a small upset over the Indians here this evening. As they're trying to keep themselves alive in the top of Iowa West race. Now, what I mean by that is Bishop Garrigan wins this and they win out. Forest City then beats Lake Mills on Tuesday. And each team would have only one loss in the conference and everybody would share it. It would be Bishop Garrigan's first top of Iowa West conference championship. They've all been, ever since Bishop Garrigan's been in the top of Iowa conference, they've been won by either Forest City or Lake Mills. The Indians trying to change their lineup a little bit there in that last one. Anything they can do to try to create a spark. Here we go, set number four. Forest City needs four and five. The Indians have yet to be to a set number five this season. They don't play five sets in tournaments, and neither non-conference or conference. Actually, haven't played any non-conference outside of tournament. We will on Thursday. Forest City taking on Clear Lake. I have that one for you. All right, here we go. Bailey Meister will start serving. She's the one that got it off hot for Bishop Garrigan in set number two. We are underway in set number four. Forest City looking for that first point, and they will get it. So the Indians off with a good start. They need to build momentum and take a lead early. But Forest City will find the first one. It's 1-0 Indians. Kevin Jones will serve now for the Indians. Taken by Ellsbecker, Rosenmeier sets it up. Crooks trying to get a kill, and she does. So as we have in every set so far, we start off 1-1. And Bishop Garrigan will serve, though Forest City already through the service of Bailey Meister for the first time around. Kaylee Miller back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Rosenmeier just tries to dump it over. The Indians will keep it alive, but they hit it into the antenna. And it'll be a Bishop Garrigan point, so the Golden Bears come back and score back-to-back. And it's 2-1 Bishop Garrigan here in set number four. Ellie Kaler. This is sent up by Walker, pushed over the net. Bailey Meister, Audie Crooks trying to send one down for his city, blocks it. Kevin Jones dives after it, unable to get it though. And it's Bishop Garrigan racing out to a 3-1 lead. Biggest thing is Forest City has made a little bit of run in these sets. They just can't let Bishop Garrigan get too far ahead. And they stop it there as the serve goes into the net. So 3-2 for Forest City. Indians just need to take a big lead of their own. Over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. This one's sent long. So Forest City will tie it back up as they score two straight. And Kaylee Miller will continue to serve for the Indians. Over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. Bailey Meister will free ball into the Forest City side. It's set up by Walker. Helgeson over the net. Rosenmeier sets it up. And that one's going to get in. Gracie Ellsbecker sends it in off the top of the net. And Bishop Garrigan ends Forest City's run at 2. And it's now 4-3, Bishop Garrigan in the lead. Here comes the serve from Rosenmeier, taken by Ellie Kaler. Walker will set it up. Set at the net, blocked at the net, rather, by Bishop Garrigan. Forest City will retrieve it. Allison Walker will send it over. Crooks, though, will deny it. Send it back to the Forest City side. Shea Dillavue will just push it over. They're going to set it up. To Ellsbecker, off the hands of Kaylee Miller and out of bounds. Back-to-back points for the Golden Bears. It's 5-3. Bishop Garrigan with the lead. 5-3 here in set number four. The Golden Bears lead 2-1 in our sets tonight. Allison Walker pushed over by Kaylee Miller. Here comes the Golden Bears. It's blocked to the net. It's going to be a Forest City point. As they're going to say, four hits. It wasn't blocked. It went into the net, came back, then. So four hits on the Golden Bears. Their run ends at 2. And Forest City's got the ball back. They're serving. Over to the Bishop Garrigan side. They're going to set it up to Crooks. And she sends it in. So it's in. 6-4 is the score. And we will see a serve coming for the Golden Bears. Allison Walker over the net, taken by the Golden Bears. This one's free balled back to the Forest City side. Here comes Shea Dillavue over the net. Kevin Jones, Allison Walker sets it up. Hannah Anderson just free balls it over. And Bishop Garrigan's into the net. It'll be a Forest City point. So the Indians will come back and score. It's 6-5. First time Bishop Garrigan's been one and done in this one. It's 6-5. And the Indians will serve with Allison Walker. This is the portion of the rotation that Forest City needs to go after and get something. They take 6-3 out of the front row as her rotation moves to the back, and Forest City finds the first point. And we're tied at 6. So Audie Crooks has to go to the bench because her spot in the rotation rotates to the back row. And 6-6. This is where the Indians need to go on a little bit of a run and get that lead before she comes back in for three rotations. Allison Walker comes in, and they got other playmakers, but he put 6-3 in front of a net. It's tough. And that one's sent long by Forest City. Two-point run is all Forest City's been able to muster up in the last couple of sets. Excuse me, 3 points. Here come the Indians. Shalulu over the net. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Kaylin Myers. Forest City's got a big dig set up by Walker, pushed over by Shea Dillavu, Bailey Meister. Here come the Indians now. Walker sets it up to Hannah Anderson. That one's going to get in. Forest City with a little bit more spunk here in this fourth set, knowing that it's on the line. They lose, and Bishop Garrigan wins. 7-7. Shea Dillavu sent it over, and that's going to be a unreturnable ball. Nearly got returned, but Bishop Garrigan had to hustle with it and just sent it into the ceiling. Back-to-back points for Forest City now is 8-7. Indians in the lead. Kaylin Myers is blocked, and it comes back down on the Forest City side. It's going to be a Bishop Garrigan point. It's 8-8. Forest City's run ends at 2. Doesn't matter how the Indians find 25 points or how many the Golden Bears have. Forest City just has to find 25 points. Sophia Holland will find, oh man, that stays alive for Bishop Garrigan somehow. Here come the Golden Bears back with it. Now Walker, Kaylee Miller trying to send it in. Granginette over, taken by Forest City. Walker, Hannah Anderson just has to push it over. Bailey Meister sent up into the back row, and they'll keep it alive. Ellie Kaler, Walker, Kaylee Miller trying to send it in. She does. Bishop Garrigan was in the net either way. And so Forest City back into the lead, 9-8. And Hannah Anderson will go back and serve here for Forest City. 9-8 is the score. The Indians in the lead. And that one's on the line and in. Forest City will get a point back with an ace serve from Hannah Anderson. So Hannah Anderson will serve once again for the Indians. Forest City leads 10-8. This one over the net. Nope. Just short. Excuse me. And Forest City still only able to muster up 2 points in a row. Bishop Garrigan back to within one. It's 10-9. Serve coming. Bailey Meister is back to serve for Bishop Garrigan. Her serve taken by Ellie Kaler. Indians keep it alive, but are unable to go after it as they hit it 4 times. And it will be back-to-back points for Bishop Garrigan, and we're tied again at 10. And Bailey Meister will continue to serve. A couple of aces for her in this one. Ellie Kaler, Walker. Now Kaylee Miller over. Bailey Meister sets it, tries to set it up. She just lays it over. Here come the Indians. Regan Helgeson will just lay it over now. They'll set it up for Crooks, but she's blocked to the net, and it'll be a Forest City point. Definitely more spark for the Indians here in set number 4 as their match life is on the line, as the Indians have been back and forth here with Bishop Garrigan, but much better defense. 11-10 is the score in favor of Forest City. They need set 4. Big strike and down. That one's in for the Golden Bears. Kaylin Myers winds up from the right side, and she'll go back to serve after Forest City is one and done. 11-11 is the score. Myers to serve, taken by Kevin Jones. Walker sets it up. Kaylee Miller descends it over. Myers. Rosen Meyer sets it up to Elsbecker. Ellie Kaler keeps it alive. Forest City's got to go over with Allison Walker. They do. Rosen Meyer sets it up. Bonnie Crooks trying to go down with it. Forest City keeps it alive. Good dig by Kevin Jones. And Ellie Kaler is able to put it over. Can Bishop Garrigan return? Free ball from Audie Crooks. They're going to send it up to Regan Helgeson, and her strike is into the net. Back-to-back points for Bishop Garrigan. They now lead 12-11. And the Golden Bears will serve with the lead, leading 12-11. Serve. Well, nobody except for Rosenmeyer was ready. And now our officials are going to talk about it. Rosenmeyer served, and nobody else was ready to play volleyball except for her. As she served it over the net, all the Forest City girls were looking at the Forest City sidelines. And so we got a little pause here. Bishop Garrigan leading Forest City 12-11. They lead in set counts 2-1. Forest City needs set 4 and set 5 to keep things alive here and to keep their conference undefeated streak on the line. It's the first time ever Bishop Garrigan has ever taken more than one set away from Forest City. Golden Bears have only took their first ever set from the Indians last year. Forest City has never lost a set to the Golden Bears until last year, and now had never lost 2 in 1 year to Bishop Garrigan, but the Golden Bears have 2 here tonight and lead 2-1. And still a conversation going on across the way between our officials, and we'll see what the ruling is. Jump ball is being signaled, but is there any point deductions for, well, we've had that in Forest City game before where somebody was on a rotation for 2 rotations and it was unknown. Forest City ended up losing a couple of points. I think we're okay now. 12-11 is the score in favor of the Golden Bears, and they will serve with Kaylin Myers. It tips into the net, and Audie Crooks is unable to return it at the net, and Forest City will, thankfully get that one, as that was nearly a Bishop Garrigan 2-point lead. 2-point run for the Golden Bears ends. Forest City will get the serve back, and we're tied at 12. Kaylee Miller will serve, taken by Kaylin Myers. Rosen Myers setting it up to Gracie Elsbecker, who slams it in for a Bishop Garrigan point, and Forest City's one and done again, and it's 13-12. Forest City has not scored more than 2 points in a row in this set. They didn't score more than 3 points in a row in the last 2 sets combined. Drop serve taken by the Indians. Shea Dillavue will just have to free ball it over to the Bishop Garrigan side. Ani Crooks now trying to punch one in. Forest City keeps it alive. They got to go over with it, though. Kevin Jones is unable to do so. And it's back-to-back points for Bishop Garrigan, and they lead 14-12. 14-12, Bishop Garrigan in the lead. Serve coming. Walker pushes it over. Bishop Garrigan able to keep it alive. They free ball to the Forest City side. Allison Walker to Shea Dillavue down the line and in. Back-to-back points for Bishop Garrigan ends there as Forest City gets one back, and it's 14-13. Forest City trails by 1. And a must-win set for the Indians. Ellie Kaler sends it over. Taken by Meister. Set up by Audie Crooks. Over the net, Forest City. No. So the Golden Bears lead 15-13. Lead by 2. And Tara Krohn will come in and serve for the Golden Bears. Walker just dumps it over. Elsbecker, Myers run into each other. Grand Jeanette just has to take it over. Allison Walker sets it up to Shea Dillavue over the net, off of Krohn's hands and out of bounds. So Forest City will get one back. And it's 15-14. The Indians back to within 1. But still trailing. Bishop Garrigan 15, Forest City 14. Bishop Garrigan leads 2-1 in the set counts. Allison Walker to serve for the Indians. Meister, Grand Jeanette takes it over. Forest City's trying to keep it alive. They got a free ball it over, they do. Back the other way for Bishop Garrigan. Grand Jeanette blocked at the net. There's a battle for it. Bishop Garrigan gets it to the Forest City side, and Forest City scores with Kaylee Miller. Kind of a free ball there for Kaylee Miller, and Bishop Garrigan mistimed the jump and was unable to get it back over, and it's going to be 15-15. Back-to-back points for the Indians. We're tied at 15, and Allison Walker will send this one over. And it's going to be an ace serve for Allison Walker. And a big moment for the Indians. They score three straight for the first time in this set, and now lead 16-15. The Indians have to have this one, and they're leading. Kaylin Meyer sets it up to Rosenmeyer, pushed over by Elsbacher. Now Forest City will go with Holland. She's just going to send it over, and Bishop Garrigan, Hannah Anderson, just blops it over, taken by the Golden Bears, and a strike is going to be off the scoreboard, off of Forest City, and an electric crowd is on their feet. Right in front of us, the Bishop Garrigan student section. And it's 16 all. Anna Anderson, Shea Dolevu over the net. Set up to Myers, and that's out. And that's a Forest City point. Forest City leads by one. And Forest City, a big dig. They got to get it over now from the back row. Ellie Kaler will. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Kaylin Myers with a strike. Dug out there by Ellie Kaler. Walker sets it up, and I think it's going to be a double hit called, and it is. 17-17. Bishop Garrigan wins this one. They win it all. And put themselves in a chance to share the top of Iowa West Conference title. Over by Hannah Anderson and in. Good play there by Hannah Anderson. And she scores for the Indians, and it's 18-17, Forest City in the lead. The Indians can just push it to five, then it's anybody. I mean, from there it's 0-0, and it's just whoever wins that one wins it. The sent fives are kind of like overtime. It's just 0-0. Redo. And just a layover there by Bishop Garrigan. They score. Nobody in that area for Forest City. Audie Crooks will come back in now. Her rotation comes back to the front row is what Bishop Garrigan's just been kind of hanging on for. And they get her back up front. Tie at 18-18. Ellie Kaler. Walker. Regan Helgeson off a block. It's in. And sent over. Audie Crooks is blocked to the net by the Indians, but it comes back to the Forest City side. Forest City will have to go over with Regan Helgeson. Audie Crooks just sends it over. Here comes Forest City now. And Holland down and in. Great play there by Sophia Holland. And the Indians score and make it 19-18. Nobody scored more than three in a row in this set. And it's 19-18, Forest City in the lead. Kevin Jones will send this one over. Taken by the Golden Bears. They're able to, nope, that's going to be a Forest City point. It is. Back-to-back points for the Indians. They lead by two. Forest City's largest lead in this set is 2 points. In the most crucial time, the Indians need five. The Golden Bears need seven. Who's going to get there first? Kevin Jones serve. Taken by Crooks. Crooks sends it over. Dug out by Kevin Jones. Allison Walker over to Regan Helgeson. It's off a block and in. Forest City with a three-point run. They lead by three. Bishop Garrigan wants a timeout. The Indians got to have this one, and they're leading 21-18. We come back in 30 seconds for more volleyball on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW. 21-18 is the score. 4A's City leading by three. The Indians have to have this one. As Bishop Garrigan is leading 2-1 in the set count, the Indians have to have this set. And 4A City trying to keep it light down there, trying to find a run. They don't have to have all four of them right this second. They would like to have all four of them right here in a row, but they don't have to. They would like to get a couple more, though, first before they were to lose it, if they were to lose the service. Trying to set themselves up to just need a couple at the end. Kevin Jones will serve, taken by Bishop Garrigan. Annie Crooks will just free ball it over. Ellie Kaler takes it now. Sent up by Walker. Kaylee Miller down and in. And that's a point for Forrest. No! Whoa, man. And they're going to say the Forrest City crowd erupts as they're going to call that one out. Everybody thought it was in. And that's a big call right there by the Bishop Garrigan line judge. And now the two referees are going to get together and talk about this one. That's a huge call. As the line judge on the Bishop Garrigan side, the home school gets to provide the line judges. And now Lacey Jerome and Dave Schnurr are yelling back and forth here. And the line judge is going to come over and talk about it. Lacey Jerome gives Dave Schnurr the business a little bit and gets a clap from the Forest City crowd. And they're going to call it a Bishop Garrigan point. Man, oh, man. It's a big spot. Now the both crowds are on their feet. 21-19 and an ace serve for Bishop Garrigan. They're back to within one. Bishop Garrigan back to within one. And the serve will come, taken by Forest City. Walker, Kaylee Miller over, it's blocked and out. And now Forest City will still lead by two. Forest City leads by two, it's 22-20. The lead for the Indians. Kaylee Miller will send it over, taken by the Golden Bears. Ani Crooks, blocked to the net, Forest City will take it. Walker, the Indians gotta go over with it. And it's into the net. 22-21 is the score in favor of Forest City. The Indians have to have this set. And Bishop Garrigan will serve. Ellie Kaler keeps it alive for the Indians. Bishop Garrigan into the net. Forest City wanted it to be a lift. They're not going to get it. Shea Dillavue with a big strike. Now Bishop Garrigan trying to keep it alive. They'll just lay it over, taken by the Indians. It's pushed over, and Bishop Garrigan is unable to return. Forest City is 2 points away. 23-21, Forest City leads by two, and they only need two to close this out and get us to a game five. Bishop Garrigan unable to return. It's a Forest City point. The Indians are one away. 24-21, Forest City just 1 point away from sending it to an all-decisive winner-take-all, set five. Bishop Garrigan trying to get it back over. They do. Ellie Kaler, Walker, Shea Dillavue blocked to the net. Forest City will return or receive, though. The Indians push it over. Bishop Garrigan unable to get it. It's a Forest City point. It's over. 25-21, Forest City wins. We head to game five. And the Indians need 15 more to come back and win it. Give me a minute. We'll come back in a minute on KIOW. Well, here we go. Back to Bishop Garrigan High School. It's winner take all. It's all going to be about who can make some runs here in this set. And our referee's talking with our line judges. Got to tell them, hey, you gotta be solid here. We get to a game five. And a big matchup for a conference title. Got to have everybody on our toes here. Locked in. Everybody's got to be locked in. Coaches, players, line judges, broadcasters, fans. Bishop Garrigan will, I believe they won. They had another coin toss and decision, and I believe Bishop Garrigan won it and will serve first. And it will all start with Bailey Meister, who will be that first one to serve for Bishop Garrigan once again. So winner take all. Forest City can eliminate the Golden Bears from conference title contention with the victory. Bishop Garrigan, if they win, will have a chance. No, Forest City will instead will serve first. All right, so Forest City serves first, left side. Here we go, game five. And the Indian serve will be taken by Bishop Garrigan. Over the net. It's all about runs in this game five. Even, or rather, Regan Helgeson over, taken by the Golden Bears. Kaylin Myers just lays it over. Forest City keeps it alive. They got to get it over, though. They do, and it's in. It's all about runs, and Forest City starts off with the first point. Because you can't get behind early because you don't have 25 points to try to come back. Forest City leading 1-0. Kevin Jones sends this one up, taken by the Golden Bears, and they're able to get it over. Forest City trying to keep it alive. They do. Back to the Bishop Garrigan side. Sends it up. Crooks sends it long. And Forest City leads 2-0. Very crucial to get out early, and the Indians do. Leading 2-0. Serve sends over. Bishop Garrigan takes. They set it up. Crooks, and it's in. So Bishop Garrigan scores for the first time. We do apologize. We're trying to get the camera up as high as we can, but they put the Bishop Garrigan student section right in front of us here. Taken by Forest City. Sent up, blocked to the net, back down on the Forest City side, and it's a Bishop Garrigan point. Back-to-back points for the Golden Bears after back-to-back points for Forest City, and we're tied at two. Serve coming. Kaylin Myers takes it, or serves it. Forest City takes it. Kaylee Miller sends it over. Bishop Garrigan trying to keep it alive. They do. Forest City digs it up. Kaylee Miller over, taken by the Golden Bears. This one set up, blocked at the net. It's going to be saved by the Golden Bears. Free ball back over to the Forest City side. Now Forest City will set up with Kaylee Miller. She with a big strike. Bishop Garrigan keeps it alive. Ellie Kaler, though, there to pick it up for the Indians. Forest City's got to go over with it. They do. And Bishop Garrigan is unable to return. It's a Forest City point. Three to two, Forest City in the lead. Kaylee Miller will serve for the Indians left side. Miller's serve taken by Bailey Meister. Set up to Crooks. She sends it over. Forest City digs. The Indians got to send it over this time. They do. It's blocked to the net and back down to the Forest City side at the Bishop Garrigan point. And we're tied at three. 3 points for the Golden Bears. 3 points for the Indians. Winner takes all here in set number five. Serve coming for Bishop Garrigan. Taken by Ellie Kaler. Walker sets it. Regan Helgeson over, and Bishop Garrigan unable to return. Back and forth we go. Forest City had two in a row. Bishop Garrigan had two in a row. Then each team goes one and done. Now Forest City back with another point. And it's 4-3 Indians. Bishop Garrigan sends it over with Crone. Here come the Indians. It's sent up to Shea. Delivery hammers one down. And Forest City leads by two. Any kind of a lead is a good lead in the fifth set. Forest City 5, Bishop Garrigan 3. Indians looking to go on a run. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. Ani Crooks sends it over. Taken by Kaylee Miller. Walker to the Bishop Garrigan side. Blocked by Shea DeLavoux, and it's in. three straight for the Indians, and it's 6-3, Forest City. Timeout, Bishop Garrigan. We come back for more Forest City volleyball right after this in 30 seconds. Welcome back here on KIOW. I hope you're enjoying this one. I don't know how you couldn't. Forest City leads 6-3 over Bishop Garrigan. A three-point run for the Indians, trying to keep it going, trying to get as many as they can here in a row. First one to 15 wins it all. Bishop Garrigan takes it, set up. Bonnie Crooks trying to get it over. She just lays it though. Forest City's able to dig it. Here comes Shadilovu, and Bishop Garrigan's in the net. And Forest City will get another one. Four straight now for the Indians. And it's 7-3. Ellie Kaler will send it over. Taken by the Golden Bears. It's set up and out. And it's 8 for the Indians. Forest City with 5 straight, and the Indians have taken a commanding lead. 8-3, Forest City here in set number 5. The Indians just need to close it out now. Ellie Kaler will serve. Taken by Bailey Meister. It's an awkward take for her, and it's just got to be free ball to the Forest City side. They can set it up for a spike. Hannah Anderson, though, gets it over. Didn't get the one she wanted. Indians thought it was a double hit. Referees say no. This one set up to Shea Dillavu. Dillavu bats it in to the Bishop Garrigan side. They send it up to Elsbecker. She slams one in. So Bishop Garrigan will get one back, but that's okay if you're Forest City. You got the lead. You just can't let Bishop Garrigan go on a run of their own now. Garrigan will serve. That means Forest City will have an opportunity to set one up and try to send one home. Crown will serve, taken by Ellie Kaler. It's sent up to Shea Dillavu, and she bats it into the net. Back-to-back for the Golden Bears now, and it's 8-5. And Crown will serve once again. Crown serve, taken by Kevin Jones. Set up by Walker. Hannah Anderson over, taken by Crown. It's sent up to Elsbecker. In the air, Forest City has got a long ways to go to get this one back over the net. They do with Ellie Kaler. Crone now sets it up. Free ball, and it's in. Three straight for Bishop Garrigan, and it's 8-6. Golden Bears back to within 2. Forest City looking for a stop. Crone sends it over, taken by Kevin Jones. Walker sets it up. Shea Dillavu over, back to Crone. Sent up by Rosenmeier. Here's Elsbecker. She sends it way long. So Forest City got the stop they needed. Bishop Garrigan got 3, though. And the Indians get 1 point closer. Allison Walker will come in to serve. 9-6. Forest City needs 6 more. Taken by Myers. It's set up at the net. Grand Jeanette. Dug out by the Indians. Comes off the ceiling. Forest City wants to have to free ball it over. They do to Bailey Meister. It's set up. Trying to go to Elsbecker. She just has to tip it over, and it's in for a Bishop Garrigan point. 9-7 is the score. Bishop Garrigan back to within 2. Forest City trying to get the Golden Bears one and done here. Holland over the net. Bailey Meister, it's sent up. Myers, and it's blocked in. Bishop Garrigan back to within 1, and now Forest City wants a timeout. 9-8, we are in the closing portion. Here is set number 5. We're gonna keep it right here. Set number 5 it is. Forest City went on the set's largest run of the set of 5 points to take a lead, but now Bishop Garrigan has come back and taking runs of 3 and now on a run of 2 to get back to within 1 point. It's 9-8. Winner take all here in set number five. Forest City wins. We mentioned a couple of times they will eliminate Bishop Garrigan from the conference race and try to set up that winner take all conference championship with Lake Mills a week from tonight. If Bishop Garrigan wins, then Forest City has to win to create a tie in the conference. And we're back to volleyball. Serve coming for Bishop Garrigan, Forest City leading 9-8. The serve is into the net, or rather on the top of the net. Forest City able to get it back over to the Bishop Garrigan side, though. Here comes Myers, it's blocked. Forest City will take. Walker, they got to go over. They do with Kaylee Miller. They keep it alive. A block, and it's a Forest City point. Man, oh man, the senior Kaylee Miller coming up big for Forest City and keeping it alive. The Indians will be able to serve again. It's 10-8. Forest City serves with the lead. And Shea DeLavue will send it over. Taken by the Golden Bears. Myers blocked. Forest City's got to send it over. They do with Kaylee Miller. Back row, it's out. Just a bit long. And it's 10-9. Bishop Garrigan back to within one again. Audie Crooks will come in for the Golden Bears. On a substitution. And Bailey Meister will serve. Taken by DeLavue. Now Walker. Kaylee Miller sends it over. Taken by Meister. It's set up. Myers over. Ellie Kaler. Allison Walker. Forest City's got to get over with Kaylee Miller. They do. It's sent up. Trying to get it to Audie Crooks. She's got it in off a block. Walker. Now Kaylee Miller just has to go over with it. Taken by Bishop Garrigan. It's sent up. Kaylin Myers off a Forest City block and out of bounds. And we're tied at 10. Down the stretch, it's been all Bishop Garrigan after it was all Forest City to start with in this fifth set, and it's 10-10. Bailey Meister will continue to serve. Taken by Walker, over to Kaylee Miller. Back to the Forest City side, and Kaylee Miller bats it into the net. And three straight for Bishop Garrigan. They lead 11-10. The Golden Bears now in the lead for the first time. Since they were led 2-1, rather no, the first time in the set. And the serve's into the net. Bailey Meister serves it into the net. The run stops at 3 and we're tied at 11. 11-11 is the score. Serve will come from Hannah Anderson. For the Indians, her serve. It's a low lining serve and it's punched out of bounds by the Golden Bears. And Forest City leads now 12-11. Forest City just 3 points away. 12-11 is the score. And Hannah Anderson will serve it for the Indians from the middle of the left side. Serve taken by the Golden Bears. Bailey Meister. Audie Crooks just has to free ball it. Shea DeLavue sets it up to Holland, who sends it a bit long. And we're tied again at 12. 12-12 is the score. And Bishop Garrigan will have the serve back. 12-12. Serve is coming. Kaylin Myers taken by the Indians. A big block of the net keeps it alive for Bishop Garrigan. Audie Crooks will free ball it over. Forest City bats it up in the air. The Indians have to go over with it with Regan Helgeson. They do. Here come the Golden Bears now from the back row. They'll just free ball to the Forest City side. Ellie Kaler puts it up to Walker. Walker to Kaylee Miller, who puts it in for Forest City. And the Indians now lead 13-12. This is a big point right here because if Forest City can win this point, they'll be 1 point away. Without Bishop Garrigan being able to get within one. Kevin Jones sends it over, taken by the Golden Bears. And they have to free ball it over. Taken by Forest City. Walker, Kaylee Miller. Taken by the Golden Bears. They've got to go over with it now. And it's blocked in there by Regan Helgeson. Forest City is 1 point away as Regan Helgeson bats that one in. Indian fans are on their feet. Forest City 1 point away from a comeback victory. And timeout called by the Golden Bears. 30 seconds. We come back to see if Forest City can win it right here on KIOW. Back to Bishop Garrigan High School we go. Forest City trying to close it out. The Indians can do so with a victory here. And they can keep Bishop Garrigan away from that conference championship in volleyball. Kevin Jones will serve. Taken by Bailey Meister. It's set up to Andy Crooks. It's blocked off and out of bounds. At the Bishop Garrigan point. Forest City still can win it here. Forest City still can win it, 14-13. Indians score here, they can still win it. Taken by Ellie Kaler, set up by Walker. Kaylee Miller, taken by Bishop Garrigan. They can't get it, it's over! It's over, and Forest City wins! Forest City wins! Forest City wins! The Indians fall behind two sets to one. They come back. They take set three. They take set four. 15-13 the final. And the Indians have eliminated everybody from the conference race except for Lake Mills. It's a showdown for the title next Tuesday in Forest City between the Bulldogs and the Indians. What a finish that was. The Indians faced some adversity. Had a rough set three. I think they would tell you every day that a rough set three, they come back and take set four, and then they take set five to win it here at Bishop Garrigan High School. Man, oh man, the Indians face some adversity, but they keep the conference streak alive. The Indians still have not lost to a team unranked this season, and they win it here at Bishop Garrigan High School tonight, 15-13 in set number five, 3-2. Man, oh man, that was fun. We'll take a break. We'll come back in 2 minutes to close this one out with the Waldorf University postgame show right here on KIOW. Welcome back here on KIOW to Bishop Garrigan High School as we wrap this one up. This is the Waldorf University postgame show. Our postgame shows are brought to you by our friends at Waldorf University of Forest City. Waldorf supports our local athletes and looks forward to helping them further their education and their careers. Find out more and how to become a warrior today at waldorf.edu. That's waldorf.edu. warriorcollege.edu to learn how to become a Warrior today. Well, it's a heart pounder here at Bishop Garrigan High School, but the Indians are able to keep it alive and have now won their eighth in a row against the Golden Bears. And again, we mentioned Bishop Garrigan taking their first, or taking two sets against Forest City in one match for the first time ever, and nearly came away with it after a big set three for the Golden Bears. We'll take you back through it. Forest City had a big lead after a couple of big runs of 4 and 6 in set number one. And Bishop Garrigan comes back at the end, though, of set number one, takes 7 straight points, but Forest City able to close it out 25-23 in set two. Bishop Garrigan 25-13 over Forest City in set number three, 25-11 over Forest City. So a couple of dominating sets for the Golden Bears set them up to go into set number four with a chance to win it. Forest City, though, comes back and able to clutch it out at the end and win 25-21 in set number four. And then from there, once you get to set number five, everybody just clears the board. Nobody from there, you can just take it. Nobody's got any set wins. First one to find 15 points, at least if we don't go longer, wins it. But Forest City able to come away with it. 15-13, the final score in this one, as Forest City will move to 7-0 in the conference race. They are 13-7 overall. And Forest City has eliminated everybody from the conference race except for Lake Mills. They will set up, barring Lake Mills. I know Lake Mills did beat North Iowa tonight in straight sets as well. So we should have a conference showdown in Forest City on Tuesday night between the Indians and the Bulldogs. And for Forest City, they escape here with that narrow victory. 3-2. Let's add them up now all time. It's 21-3 Forest City set-wise. And as we mentioned, Forest City, they win their 7th straight in this series, dating back to when Bishop Garrigan joined up with these two teams in conference play back in 2014. The year before, we made the top of Iowa Conference, the final year of the North Iowa Conference, and then in 2015 went to the top of Iowa Conference, and it's just been all Forest City since then. So once again, Forest City wins it here on the end, the Waldorf University postgame show. Waldorf University of Forest City supports our local athletes and looks forward to helping them further their education and careers. Find out how to become a Warrior today at waldorf.edu. That's waldorf.edu to learn how to become a Warrior today. Thanks to John Jacobs back at the studio for all of his hard work. We'll see you for non-conference volleyball on Thursday as the Indians will take on the Clear Lake Lions, and then a special presentation for you on Friday night as Lake Mills will take on the number 10 team in Class A, West Forks. We got a special football game for you with Forest City in quarantine. We got a special football presentation for you on Friday night between the Lake Mills and West Fork. We'll have that for you. I'll have the pregame show at 6:15 and the kickoff at 7 p.m. from Lake Mills High School. Once again, Forest City comes back to win 3-2 in set number 5 and defeat the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. We'll see you on Thursday night from Algona. I'm Zarin Agastal saying good night.